Here we have a gate underwater, and the gate has a hinge here. And the idea is that water is exerting pressure on the gate. And as we go deeper, the pressure increases linearly with depth. And what we want to be able to do is determine what's the resultant force of all this pressure and where is it located along the gate. Because eventually the idea is we'd have to exert a force here to stop the gate from opening, and we'd like to be able to calculate that. So first, let's keep in mind some of the things that are important when we do this analysis. First, the pressure is only a function of the water height. It doesn't matter what the angle is. We're going to pick one angle for this particular example. The pressure increases linearly as we increase the depth. We're going to ignore the fact that air exerts pressure on the water because air also exerts pressure on the gate, and these will cancel out. Second thing we want to take into account, the way I've drawn this, important to remember that the water force is perpendicular to the surface of the gate, and this doesn't matter what the angle is, the force of the water is going to be perpendicular in all cases. Next thing to keep in mind, as I mentioned, to make analysis easier, we're going to replace that pressure distribution by a resultant force. Next, the distance that resultant force along the gate is such that it exerts the same moment as the integrated moments from the water pressure. So we want to calculate what that distance is. And next, the gate has weight, and the weight is going to tend to keep the gate closed. And the weight is exerted at the center of the gate. Let's say it's about here, and the weight, of course, is in this direction. So let's look at the calculation, and we'll use a fresh figure. Make sure we have the notation consistent. And what we're going to do is talk about the height of the water, and it's zero here, and then it increases as we get deeper. It's positive. And then on the diagonal along the gate, y is going to be the variable. It's going to be zero here, and y is going to equal d here, and at the end of the gate, y is equal to d plus l. We mentioned we want the force on the gate, and that's perpendicular, and that distance we're going to call y sub r, resultant force location. So let's look at the calculation of the resultant force. And so the force is rho gh. And then we're going to integrate over the area to get the total force. And what we want to do is do this in terms of the variable y. So we're integrating along the gate direction. Area of the gate is going to be L times the width of the gate, how deep into the screen we would go. And so this is equal to rho g, they're constants. The gate area is going to be b times dy. That'll be dA. And I'm going to replace h by y sine of theta, where theta is this angle here. Sine theta is a constant, so that's outside the integral. And I have integral of y dy, and we're going to integrate. Of course, the force on the gate is only from y equals d to y equals d plus l. So we're going to just look at this term to do the integration, and then we'll substitute back. So this term, if we integrate, is just y squared over 2 evaluated between the limits. So I'm going to make this substitution, and then I'm going to simplify. So I've just multiplied out d plus l, and then we'll notice that this cancels with this. Notice I factored out l, and I'm going to call this term y sub c. This is the center location of the center of the gate. D down and then half of the length of the gate. And this is, of course, the location where the weight would be exerted that tends to keep the gate closed. So I can now write out my complete equation, and B times L is the area of the gate. And so here's the force, the first thing that we want to calculate. I should mention we're calling this YC because this is the centroid of the gate. So the second part of our calculation is we want to calculate the location of this force. And so the way we're going to do that, distance is Y sub R minus D. So the force due to the water times the moment arm, that would give us the torque that's trying to open the gate. And then we want to locate Y sub R by integrating the force, rho gh, like before, times y minus d. So y increases as we move in this direction, and we're adding up all those forces, and we're again integrating over the area. Well, we're going to make the same substitutions that we did previously. So I bought outside the integral, the terms that are constant. And again, we're integrating from D to D plus L. For now, just look at this term. So integrating this Y squared term here, is all in Y cubed, and integrating Y was the Y squared term. I can now make this substitution and then simplify. And I can simplify these terms using a common denominator. So now I have terms I can add together and further simplify. So I can substitute this back up here, and I likewise will substitute on the left side, including putting in the value for FR that we calculated earlier in this screencast. So I just copy the equation down again that I made the substitution, and then we can certainly simplify because rho g sine theta cancels on both sides of the equation. The area of the gate, remember, is b times the length. Just substitute b times the length for the area of the gate. Then b also cancels. So now I solve for y sub r minus d, the distance of the resultant force from the hinge. This then tells us where that resultant force is located. And remember that y sub c is d plus l over 2. So now we calculate the force and we've calculated the location. We can then use this to calculate what's the force needed to keep the gate closed.